Hi there, my name is Sarah, and I'm really excited to be sharing with you today my one secret for fast success with Amazon KDP and creating like low content books and selling them super quickly. So honestly, like with the secret, I'm really excited to share it with you, but at the same time, I'll admit I'm a little bit hesitant because like this is honestly a big secret. You're probably not gonna hear about it anywhere else. You might, but I'm gonna be going into it like I feel like with a lot more depth than you might hear from other people. And I'll be showing you examples that other people have created, examples that I've created, and how I've found success with this secret. So let's just dive right in. To break it down in one simple word, the secret is categories. The category of your low content book is like one of the most important aspects with its success. Basically, like there are two important aspects when you're creating your low content book. Basically, the first one is the design. If it doesn't look pretty, if it's not a style that anyone likes, no one's gonna buy it, end of story. But at the same time, if it does look good, you need to be doing what you can to make sure it gets in front of the right audience so that it gets purchased. And there are mainly two ways to do this. Well, I mean, there's pretty much one way, which is making sure that you keyword properly. That's one like important strategy. The other one is categories. So let's talk first really quickly about what categories is. So when you're creating low content books, you'll see here, so this is in Kindle Direct Publishing, KDP. So if I were to create a book, here's all the info that I would have to put in. And at the very bottom, at the almost very bottom, there's this category section. This is where I'd choose up to two browse categories. I'll show you exactly what that is in a second. But basically I can choose two categories from like this whole selection of bunch of different categories. So here's what categories are. If I pop over to Amazon, go down to books, just press enter and let it bring up what it brings up. Basically, so categories is basically Amazon trying to create some form of like a bookstore online. So you know when you go to a bookstore, there are a bunch of different sections. Like if you want to go and read the science fiction, you'll probably find a science fiction section. That's what Amazon is aiming to do here. So if I wanted, I don't know, a book on business and investing, I'd click on this. And if I wanted a more specific a category, would go over here, like accounting. Sure, let's look for an accounting book. And if I want to go even more specifically, we'll see over here. So we're under books, business and money, accounting, and then, I don't know, auditing. So then we're going to find a whole bunch of books on auditing now. So yeah, this is basically in a nutshell what categories are. This is like the only, like this is, I don't know, this is basically what Amazon's goal is with categories, but there is a much bigger goal that we can have with categories than just, you know, getting into this little section here. Okay, so basically categories are not that important. I mean, think about it, like Harry Potter is probably already like dominating over in like the fantasy category. Your book, your cute little composition book, your cute little notebook, your cute little log track or whatever it is not gonna make it ahead of that. So what you need to do is to make sure that you're targeting smaller categories that people aren't really gonna be looking for. So basically these are the browse categories. This is Amazon's main goal. Like Amazon wants you to come in here and find a category and look for a book, but most people don't do that. That's the thing. Like if people want to look for a fantasy book, they'll go and look for a fantasy, but they're probably not going to go in here and look for a financial auditing book. They'll just come up here into the search bar and they'll type it as opposed to just going through the category. Cause honestly, let's be honest, it's a bit painful when you just search for financial auditing rather than going through each individual category. So, okay, now let me show you, we're gonna go back to all departments. We're gonna show you the main culprit here. So this unicorn composition notebook, there are a bunch of them. They're all ranking for some interesting things. So basically categories, I don't think I've explained it very well quite yet, but categories are what are going to help you rank in the Amazon search bar. So right here in unicorn composition books, you'll see some that like are ranking like more organically, like they weren't trying to like hack or anything. Like this one right here, it's ranking here like 3,454 in books. So this is the BSR, the bestseller rank. Basically this is a small calculation of how many sales it's making. So it's not like 3,454. If you go over, there's this website, TCK Publishing Created, where you can plug that in, 3,454. I go in here, book. So basically, here's a little calculator, sort of an average of how many sales it's making per month and sales it's making daily. So that's what that means. And then over here, we have the category, like where it's ranking in the category. So currently it's number 67 in study guides and workbooks. And the thing is, the ranking in this category is having a large impact on its ranking overall, which is why, like, this helps a ton. So here, like, this is pretty normal, study guides and workbooks. But we're gonna go over here and we'll see some other interesting things. Here's another one, this one's kind of normal. This one's interesting. So it's ranking fairly well. Yeah, this is actually ranking pretty well. It's number one in Viz Publisher Comics and Graphic Novels and number one in Horse Showing and Training. Doesn't really relate to either of those things. It's just a composition book. Same over here, office equipment and supplies. Yeah, sure. But then we've also got number 11 in Antiques and Collectibles. And it's ranking very well right here. And now let me show you one that's like really weird, but like is having an incredible difference on its overall ranking. So here we've got this one at number 267 in books. Like, honestly, that's incredible. It's making like thousands per month, I'm pretty sure. And it's number one in astrophysics and space science. And it's also number one in insurance law, business law, which I don't know if you're seeing what this is, but this is just a cute little unicorn primary composition notebook. It has absolutely nothing to do with astrophysics and space or insurance law, business law. So, as you can see, the category, basically, it makes no difference, but at the same time, it makes a world of a difference. So you can just throw whatever category you want in there, and like, it doesn't really matter. But at the same time, it's the category that you choose that is going to help your book rank well overall. So you want categories that aren't being used very much. Like, if you go over, let's go back here and take a look back in categories. So ones that will probably be a bit more popular. So if we go into, I don't know, juvenile fiction. So juvenile fiction, like just children's fiction books. We go down to fantasy and magic. This one's probably used a lot because, you know, a child's fantasy book like Harry Potter, it might be ranking for this category, honestly. And there are probably going to be a ton of other books ranking for this category. But a more, but a category that isn't quite as widely used. So if we just go to nonfiction, go down to performing arts, film and video, history and criticism. This one probably is used very rarely. So this is a great category for your book to rank. Now let me show you a couple quick examples from what I've created. I recently created a bunch of new composition notebooks. For example, so this one right here, this one's mine. It's currently ranking pretty well in brunch and tea cooking, as well as gourmet cooking. So one thing I noticed, so when I first started creating composition books, it did take a while for me to start selling them. But then eventually, like, I've sort of figured out little tricks here and there, and now, like, they're just selling, like, so much better. Like, I'd make, like, what, 10 flower ones, and then one of them would sell, like, fairly consistently, and that was great. But with these strawberry ones, I have better employed this fancy technique that I'm currently telling you about, and it has helped multiple sell and multiple rank. So here's this one. Here's where it's ranking. Another one down lower. This one is doing really well, honestly. This is actually, it was ranking better earlier. It just varies depending on, like, as time passes and whether it gets sales or not. But see, it's 193 in food counters and 248 in organic gardening and horticulture, which are very, very random categories, which could maybe relate because it's strawberries, food. That's kind of where I was going with it. But basically, I've created these strawberry books. This one I created, this one I created, I created that one. This one has sold. So basically, I created like, what, 9 strawberry composition books, and already like 4 of them have sold. And I think honestly, a lot of it helps with the categories. So to break it down even more, I'm kind of just explaining like as I go and giving you bits and details if you couldn't tell. The thing with the categories, so you want to start with a great design, because a great design is what's going to sell. And then once you get that first sale, that's going to help it rank. Because as you'll see, like down here, one of these ones, BSR is undefined. That means that the book hasn't sold yet, but sometimes it can just be that way. Because this one, I know this one sold, but it says BSR is undefined. It might just be slow for that one. But basically, this means it hasn't sold yet. But once it sells once, like, it's going to get a BSR rank. It's going to start ranking for these categories. And if it's in these lower competition categories, then that means it's going to rank better overall. So once you get that one sale, it's going to just suddenly rank much higher than it might regularly. And then it'll like come up in search results much quicker. So basically, here's the example with the books that I've created. And they've been doing really, really well. Like, I recently, posted like a YouTube video, I think like 3 weeks ago, about like how much I've made so far, like within the month of my starting. And it's already been like 3 weeks since then, and it's honestly skyrocketed. I'm gonna need to post another video to show how much more I've made. But honestly, I've been figuring this out, and like this is a excellent little hack. If you wanna start making sales fast, like, this is what you do. That's about it for my little secret. So another, like, just a quick recap. Start with a gorgeous design. Like, it has to look good. And then make sure you do some keyword research. And once you've done like that research and figure out like what, let me show you really quickly. KDP Spy, excellent Chrome extension that'll help you like figuring out like keywords and things. It's great. So go with that keyword. Make sure to put those keywords inside your title and in your description, everything. And then once you've done that, go to your categories. Choose weird categories that you might not like think would ever get like chosen. Health and daily living, daily activities, and juvenile fiction. Super random. Another one. Let's go to regular nonfiction, medical, allied health services, medical technology. Both super duper random categories, but because these categories are lower competition, once you get that one sale, it's gonna help your book rank so much better overall, and it's honestly just gonna be incredible, and you'll be getting sales much more rapidly than if you just create like a nice design, maybe keyword research a little bit, and then just do boring categories or even no categories at all. Like, it's probably not gonna like make it to the top quite as quickly. So yeah, that is about it. I hope that this secret has helped you, and I hope that you use it in creating and publishing your low content books. Let me know in the comments down below how it goes, because honestly, it's been doing really well for me, and I'd love to hear how it works for you. Anyway, I hope you have a fabulous rest of your day, and I hope that you find success with creating and publishing low content books. Bye.